Hello and welcome to this video on how to use Silhouette Studio to customise the colours in SVG files. This video is specifically recorded for Silhouette users on a Silhouette machine, but if you have a different type of machine, don't worry, I have separate videos for you too. If you have a Cricut machine or a Scan and Cut machine, head to craftwithsarah.com/help to find the specific tutorials for your machine. But if you've got a Silhouette, this is the right video for you. So let's dive straight in and see how to recolor SVG files using Silhouette Studio. Let's get started. I'm using Silhouette Studio Designer Edition for this video. If you've got the free version of Silhouette Studio, also known as the Basic or Standard Edition, then your screen probably won't look exactly like mine and you won't have access to all of the options that I'm going to show. One of the real drawbacks of the free version of Silhouette Studio is that you can't open SVG files. Instead, you have to rely on DXF files, which is a slightly different file type. And when you load them into Silhouette Studio, everything appears with no colour in it, so you'd have to manually recolour every single layer yourself. With the Designer Edition or upwards, all of the colours come in when you load the SVG file, so it's much easier to work with the designs. Silhouette Studio is a one-off cost to upgrade to the Designer Edition or any of the higher up versions. It's not a monthly or yearly subscription. To get the Designer Edition is around about $40, although it can vary a little bit. If you're going to be using your Silhouette machine for lots of papercraft projects, I strongly recommend upgrading because it will make your life so much easier and give you access to way more options within the software. If you are using the free version of Silhouette Studio, head to craftwithsarah.com/help, choose Silhouette from the list of machines on the screen, and then look at the video on how to make layered cardstock designs with a Silhouette machine, as that includes a section on how you can load the designs using the free version with a little bit about changing the colours. Alright, so after my very long intro spiel, let's crack on with changing these colours. We'll start by learning the basics. Let's go into shapes and I'll choose an oval and draw a couple of these on the screen. Now these are all appearing as transparent at the moment with a red border around the edge. Like many design softwares, Silhouette Studio gives each layer or shape two different colour options. There's the fill option, which is the colour that the main shape or layer will appear, and the stroke option, which is the line going around the edge. At the moment, we can see by having this circle selected and looking at the very top, the fill option, which is this one here, is showing as a kind of grid of squares, which means that it's transparent. The stroke option is the one next to it, which is showing as red. I can go into the fill option and then choose any of these colours to change it. And you see that's now filled it in with that fill colour. If I want to change the stroke, I can go into here and choose a different colour, and then I could also change the type of line to a dashed line or use these arrows to make the line thicker. Bear in mind when you're doing this that it doesn't actually cut the line as something separate, it would all still be the same shape. You can remove the stroke by clicking on the layer that you want to amend, going into here and then choosing the little square option, and that will remove the stroke for you. If I change the colour of this one, let's give it a fill colour of green, and I'll remove the stroke. If you want to change the colour to one that's already used, you can click the one you want to change, go into the colour box and press this colour dropper tool, and then click onto the colour that you want to change it to. And then let's also take that one out. And then one more, we could go in another colour completely. Let's try a red, and again, remove the stroke. To see more colour options, you can click on a layer and then go into the palette icon down the right side of the screen. This pops up something very similar to what we were looking at along the top, but there are a couple of other options. For instance, we can click and drag through more choices here. We could make the shape transparent if you want to, although bear in mind that doesn't actually change how it will cut out. Or if you know the computer code, the hexadecimal code for the colour you want to add in, you can type that in there. Hexadecimal codes are 6-digit codes that your computer uses so that it knows what colour to show you on your computer monitor. It doesn't relate to any particular type of vinyl, cardstock, or other type of craft material. Next, let's take a look at recolouring an SVG file. I've downloaded one of the free SVGs from my website, which is the Valentine's Day themed flower pot design. First, let's get the SVG file open by going File, Open, and then make sure you've unzipped the version of the download folder and go to that unzipped version. There are lots of different versions of the files included in your download folder. The one which will be probably easiest for Silhouette Studio is going to be 02 layers stacked, or the alternate would be 04 separated by colour, but I'm going to go for the stacked one because that will make it easier for recolouring. In the stacked version, all the layers come one on top of the other so it looks like a finished picture on the screen, whereas the separated by colour, they're grouped by the colours all in different places. So I'll go into layers stacked, and then choose the file that starts SVG. And here's what it looks like. Zoom out a bit. First things first, I'm going to click on the page setup and change my media size to 12 by 12, just so that I can see that all in white. It makes it a little bit easier. Now that I've got white layers on a white background, it's a bit hard to see them. So just while I'm recoloring this, I'm gonna drag a box around everything and then give it a stroke, just a black line all around the edge. Now I can see all of those white pieces a lot better on the screen. Let's zoom in a little bit more too. All right, so let's say that I wanted to change all of the white layers to gold. I can click on one of them and then go into the color palette and choose a nice goldy color. And then I could do the same for the other ones, but this time I'll click the color picker and make that the exact same gold I've already used. And then do the same there. That's looking nice, but I think we could go one step further with these little hearts inside the flowers too. So once again, I'll click all of those and change it to gold. And then very quickly and easily, I've recolored all of those bits I want to change. This would now be ready to be prepared to be cut out. So I'd need to separate out all of the colours so that I can cut them onto their individual mats. And I'd also probably want to resize this too to match the project I'm making. For full instructions on how to do that, head to craftwithsarah.com/help, choose Silhouette from the list of machine options, and then have a look at the tutorial, which is on how to make layered cardstock projects with a Silhouette machine. For this video, we're just focusing on the recolouring. Let's take a look at one more example. This is another free SVG from my website. If you'd like to make a different dog breed, head to craftwithsarah.com/products, and from there you can choose from over 200 different types of dog. Plus there's loads of cats, horses, small pets, basically any animal you can think of. Let's pretend we're making this for a friend who's got a chocolate coloured labradoodle instead of the goldy colour we can see here. So we'll need to change all the colours of the dog to a dark chocolate colour instead. I prefer to work from the bottom upwards, but if you prefer it the other way around, that's absolutely fine. First things first, some of these pieces are a little bit hard to see where one ends and the next one begins. For example, on the face, we've got two pieces here of the same colour, one on top of the other, so it is a bit hard to tell what we need to change. To make it easier, drag a box around everything, and once again, just give it a stroke, so that now we can see all those bits more clearly. All right, so I'm gonna click on my very bottom layer, and sometimes, although I've managed to do it that time, sometimes it's hard to select the correct layer when you've got two layers where the edges perfectly meet each other. If you're having that problem and you keep clicking on the wrong one, go into the layers panel, which is this option down here. Open this up, and now this will show all the layers in the design. As I click each one, you can see it's selecting each of those pieces. As I'm starting at the bottom, if I press layer one right at the bottom of this list, that's going to be the very bottom one, which is the one I want to change. So now I can go into the color option and choose a nice rich brown. And then for the one on top, I'll go for a darker brown. If you want to cut this without the flowers, then you can do that either by just moving the flower layers out of the way or by deleting them by hitting the delete key on your keyboard. I have a separate video on how to remove the flowers and how to customise the layers a little bit more. For that, again, go to craftwithsarah.com/help and choose the silhouette option. But I am going to do all of them to show you what it looks like, so let's put that back. Okay, now for the next one, this next light colour, we'll colour pick to that brown we used there. And then the flowers will be colour picked to the darker flowers. And now moving on to the head, it's got three colours in it at the moment, but I'm going to change mine to just two. Start with the ears, and as these are already the darkest colour of the existing colours, I'm going to follow that same logic and make that my darker brown. And then for the head, we'll go for the lighter one. There's one more colour here in that same sort of sandy colour, so we can go lighter on that one. And then I think probably dark eyebrows and then a light muzzle. And you can see just how quick and easy it really is to change the colours to make the design better match the particular dog or animal that you're trying to replicate. If you want to, you can have the same colour on multiple layers that are next to each other. For instance, I could cut the face out like that, and although it looks a little bit weird on the screen having all the bits the same colour, when you've cut it out from your cardstock and you're sticking it together, it will still work and you'll be able to see all the details and shapes in your finished paper craft. That's because some of the pieces will be stuck together using foam squares to give it some dimension and depth, following the assembly guide that's included in all of my download folders. Once you've done that, then you'll get natural shadowing between each of the layers, which helps to focus the eye on all the different pieces and make it look just perfect. But I think I actually did prefer that at the slightly darker colour. And there we go, my chocolate brown coloured labradoodle would now be all ready for me to size and then separate out the colours ready to cut. I hope that you enjoyed this video on how to use Silhouette Studio to recolour SVG files for your craft projects. If you did, please give the video a thumbs up and subscribe to my YouTube channel for lots more Silhouette Studio tutorials. To find all of the matching tutorials from this series, head to craftwithsarah.com/help. Or for over 100 free SVGs to use with your Silhouette machine, go to craftwithsarah.com/free-SVGs. Thank you so much for watching this video. Bye!